Morning, the ship carrying the rocket engines of Apollo Saturn V will be arriving at Port Canaveral. An expedition led by the Amazon founder recovered the engines from the bottom of the ocean. Now, those rockets used five engines at a time to blast astronauts to the moon. And joining us live is the Today Show's Kerry Sanders. So, Kerry, thanks for joining us this morning.
Yeah, good morning. I mean, look at those engines. They're right over my shoulder. That's the Saturn V rocket, mammoth rocket. And those are five of the engines in one of the stages there. Just gigantic. And what happened is, as the Apollo missions would lift off and as the Saturn V's were leaving Earth's gravity, it would release those stages and the engines would then fall back to Earth, splash into the ocean, and to be lost really forever until now.
And Kerry, underwater treasure hunters found these rocket engines. Why search for them?
Well, you know, it's a little bit of what was really inside the mind of Jeff Bezos. That is the founder of Amazon, you know, the website that people go and shop on. Well, he's a billionaire now, but he was a little kid growing up in Miami and could literally see the burn of the rockets from his yard in South Florida as the Apollo missions were take off. You got to know how much the Apollo missions captivated this nation's attention. And if you're of a right age, you certainly remember that. Well, Jeff Bezos never forgot. Now he had the money and still had the interest to find those engines. And so put his money where his ideas were, and for more than a year has been out there trying to find them, located. What we don't know is, are these the Apollo 11 F1 engines? It's going to take a little bit of time to confirm that, but he has a pretty good feeling that that's what he has found.
Oh, and Kerry, just it's so amazing. It's so neat to see such history there. So before you leave us, what's the plan for these now? To be restored, and can we tour them soon and take a look?
Well, soon might not be the answer that you want to hear, but eventually. And it's unclear, but remember, Jeff Bezos now lives on the West Coast up in the Seattle area. So it's unlikely that these engines will remain in our area here in the Space Coast. But eventually, I believe that's what he suggested he will do, is put them on display for all to see and really to marvel at. You know, one of the experts told me that those engines, which were quite complicated, were a plumber's nightmare. There were so many twists and turns. And so to examine them by today's technical standards, and a little bit of awe to consider that what they were able to do and put together at the time that they did to launch man to the moon. Quite amazing.
Oh, wow. Well, thanks so much for joining us this morning, Kerry. We certainly appreciate it.